think we're ready to flip it over to our guys. My favorite sitcom, Brody in the Beard. Take it away.
Can I be the beard this time?
That's okay. I got you. A little spin of Roonies.
We'll take turns. We got the flop side Tic Tacs and Precision Zed coming up. This is going to be a great match.
I got to say, that was one of the better trolls where chat actually convinced me that it was Precision Zed. Even though right afterwards, Tequila's is like, no, guys, no, it's Z.
It's not. It's Z. I mean, I'm Canadian, so I say Zed, but Z does sound cooler. I'll give you guys that.
For 40 minutes, they had me saying Zed, and it was so uncomfortable because that's not what I'm used to saying.
It showed. But coming into this, Precision Z, this is important for them. As the desk just said, this is very important that they take a lot of games off of this.
Very much. And James brought up a good point. Flipside is warmed up. They just played some really high-intensity games against Kapow. They almost actually lost it. They were able to pull the victory, so I'm sure they're feeling kind of good. Hopefully they're not too down that they didn't get the 4-1 or 5-0 they wanted. Because, again, they are in third, and they might be close to first, but that means they're not too far off from fourth to fifth. So they need to make sure they keep this pressure going.
No, it's very true, and as they're saying, for myself included, I love playing before and coming to a match hot. Unless you didn't play too well before, you might be a little tilted coming into that. Could be the opposite side of things. But I think it can be carried forward. Any predictions on how the series is going to go for you?
I think 4-1 in favor of Flip was a pretty good prediction as far as James went. But at the same time, I don't know what Precision Z just did. You know, I'm pretty sure they've already played a match as well, so they could be coming in just as hot.
That's true. Both teams could be coming in great. We're going to see, though, as we head down to the field, how they're playing. Precision Z versus Flipside Tactics. Getting us started off game one. We have already a cheat coming out from Flipside, or sorry, Precision, as they try to get a quick early goal. Good touch from Dudu. Trying to follow that up with some nice air tactics there.
Those have actually been getting Flipside pretty well. We saw Kapow just do a few of those to them. Mm-hmm. They're not really predicting it. Maybe they're underestimating who they're going against. They're used to being the power in the air when they're playing some of these games, but these teams have been contesting them very well.
And there's an open net that no one's going to take advantage of. Mikageshi trying to get that clear of their area. Followed up is Tequila's. He's got the Batman going on as well. Misses the touch on that. Going to leave it for the third to come in. Dudu with a good rotation, putting the pressure on. Marky and Mike trying to get that out of zone. Marky just pushing to the side to see if they can get a play started up. Mike rules.
Precision's doing a really good job of right now coming out hot, which is what you have to do against Flipside. Flipside's the kind of team that's going to make you pay, and they're making sure that does not happen.
Cooks here, good touch out, trying to get one of those infamous passing plays started up, but they get stopped in the track by Tequila's. Now Precision has a chance to move in, and they do, getting stuffed out by Cooks here, though. Tequila's waiting to catch this on his car. Not going to dribble it, though. A little bit harder with the Batmobile. Just tries to get out. Cooks here, almost a good touch. Marky almost following that one up, too.
The reads on Flipside is exactly what we like to see out of a team that's powerful. We saw it. I think Marky jumped up well before the touch even happened at a Cooks here. He knew he was going to pop it above the net. And again, this is what we see coming out of teams that have played together for months and months and months.
Marky being patient. Mike trying to get in there. He does. Gets that pass out front. Tequila's going to beat anybody from Flipside, so they just wait back. They're sending that right back into Precision's area. Trying to get that into the slot. Just putting some pressure on as they get boost filled up, and here comes a potential play as Mike and Cooks here try to get something going. They can't. Mika Geisha misses that one, and that's going to allow Flipside to try to get another attack going on.
Take a look at how some of these guys approach the ball. We just saw Cooks here in the corner. He could have easily overcommitted and tried to go for a ball that would have been really risky. But he's like, you know what? Even though I could beat them to this ball, it's not worth the commitment. It wasn't going to result in anything good. And he backed off instead, and he was able to get a counter hit to keep it in the Precision half.
Touch from Cooks here goes out to Dudu. He tries to take advantage. Doesn't go on target. Goes a little bit wide, but Tequila's there to support him. Cooks here, easy touch himself. Takes that back off the wall. Shot on target, but Mikageshi is there. Easy clear to midfield. Mike reading that one off the wall, sends it right back to him. Tequila's going to be the one to pick it up instead. Here he goes down midfield. Battle of the Batmobiles. Neither one of them winning. Sitting in neutral is the ball. Dudu and Mike trying to win that one for themselves. They can't. Mike up there for a pass, going a little bit too slow. No play's going to develop there. Mikageshi flipping under the ball.
Flipside's keeping it in the Precision half pretty frequently, but they're not really doing a whole lot out of it. They're not really taking shots on. Precision's not having to make any difficult saves. All they really have to do is rotate and get in the way.
Cooks are a good touch, but almost connected with Mikageshi. If he was a second earlier, could have been a shot on net as no one was back. Marky, Mike, and Flipside. Cooks here now have a chance to make a breakout, but they don't stuff by Tequilas. He's trying to get a play started up. Could be a pass off the wall. Not a good enough bounce. Didn't roll up. Mikageshi to support. That's a good roll up if he falls it up. But he knows Cooks here is going to beat him.
Right there was a perfect time. You just saw Mikageshi thought he was going to go for it. And instead he's like, no, you know what? I'm going to bail because I don't have an opportunity. And here they are again putting pressure on right after.
It's a good time to regroup. Get yourself set up for another attack as they tried there, but it's back into their area. Now they're going to have to fight on the defensive side of things as Mike tries to set up a play off the backboard. Mikageshi, good job rushing out to that ball, getting up before anyone could pressure that into the net. Markey doing the same thing. That's going out in front of the net. Dangerous spot. Cooks here pushing it to the side. Mikageshi backing off so Dudu can move up. Here comes Mikageshi into Dudu. Dudu. As Dudu puts one on net, but Markey gets that back to midfield.
On a counterpoint, while you do want to give up the balls that you probably aren't going to win, you don't want to not contest a lot of these shots. Flipside has had some opportunities where they can go up and 50 it in front of the precision net, and they just kind of let precision clear it for the counter hit.
Ooh, almost a bad situation there. Still a bad situation as Markey almost sinks that one, and Tequila's barely scraping that one out.
That's exactly what they have to do. They need to contest that in front of net. Yeah, you might not win it, but you're going to keep it there. You're going to pull a defender out, put him out of position, and force him to make a save that he doesn't want to make.
That's right out in front, and a shot coming from Mike. A little bit to the mid. If he got into the far side, could have been a goal, but it gets blocked out by Precision Z. Now they make a chance. Bumping into each other, going to lose control of that ball. Mikageshi not getting a touch off the wall. But to do, to follow it up. And there is Flipside with the pressure to push it back into their zone.
Both teams have to be careful. While it may seem like it's been in the side of Precision a little bit more, we're at a tie game with only 5 seconds left. One tiny mistake could put this game in either direction.
That was a shot almost from Tequilas. If you get that stuff properly, could have been the game-winning goal, but the ball is still in the air. 0-0-0-0 on that scoreboard. Donuts all around, and the pressure is still coming out from Precision Z. Let's see if they can get another play started. Dudu lets that one drop beside him.
Very smart. It was headed towards his half. He probably should have not gotten underneath that. He did a good job of letting that die.
Absolutely right. Markey now with an opportunity to push that deep in. He doesn't. Stays at midfield. Mikageshi with a great pass out to the center. Dudu doesn't connect. But the third rotation, Tequilas with the shot a little bit wide. Could have ended that one there. Still going into our overtime. Now back into Precision Z zone. They're doing a very good job of setting up plays offensively.
Flipside's a little bit slow when it's in their half, but they're faster when it's in the opposing half. And it seems like they're more comfortable when they're on offense. Sometimes they'll let the ball float a little bit too long in their own half, but they're able to pull that. My God, what a bullet coming from their own half.
Hey, sometimes you get those long shots, they go in. If you catch your opponents on a bit of a defensive malfunction, you can get those. So it's a good job just throwing it down, get recuperated, and get the play set up. Because now they're back in Precision Z zone. As I say that, back down to Flipside. As they try to get that push back out, here comes Tequilas just rushing in. Followed up by Mikageshi. This could be a shot, but Cooks here beats any of the Precision Z players to it. Dudu up with a shot off the backboard. Could be an opportunity, Mike, with a good touch of the underside to push that to the side.
That might have been a time for one of his teammates to come contest it. While it didn't look like it was going to get in front of net, no one on Flipside had a good opportunity to really slam it out. So they probably wanted to want to get above that, try and keep it in front of net, and give time for a third person.
The shot from Cooks here as it just goes over Markey or Mike. And there's another shot. The shot's just coming out right now. The scary spot to be in when Cooks is putting this much pressure on. Now the shot from Mike. Can't get it. Back to the side it goes.
I want to see the save to the end of this, see exactly how Precision she's doing, because they have saved so many shots from Flipside right now.
Ooh, this is a dangerous situation. Good placement from Mike. Finish that off a minute and a half into overtime.
They didn't save enough. Just one more shot's all it took. We had Mika waiting on the back, and then two players went for it. Not the best defensive positioning, so it's like they finally fell under the pressure that Flipside puts on so strongly.
A little bit of whiffing coming from them on the defensive side of things. Puts only a one-goal game in favor of Flipside Tactics. Again, stuck in their own zone, it felt like a lot at the end there.
Yeah, and it's just kind of not what I expected to come out right in that first game. Precision Z did a good job of keeping their wits about them, even though they had a lot of shots. I mean, this look at that, 3, 4, 5. I mean, we had, what, 7 saves?
Yeah,
I'm turning into you without being able to do math. I had to make sure. I just didn't want to get it wrong. I'd rather like slow it down.
We can be wrong together.
But 7 saves coming out. I mean, that's a lot. And none of those shots were weak or slow or easy. I mean, these were all bullets coming out from quarterfield, midfield, and that's really good. And they were able to keep their defensive structure going on while having to defend these saves. There were a couple of close calls, But towards the end, it just kind of finally fell apart, and they were able to eke one more goal, one goal in that overtime.
Yeah, as you said, insane amount of shots, only three coming out of precision Z total there. But again, it doesn't matter if none of them went in. But coming to this, any changes on either side, or do you feel like they're fairly even?
Precision wants to get out of their defense. They don't want to keep having to make these saves. Come around game three, game four, they're going to be exhausted from having to do the defensive play. They're going to get frustrated. They're going to want to inch out, and they're probably going to make some more mistakes. So they got to make sure that when it's in Flipside's half, they stay cognitive and keep it going.
Mm-hmm. There's a bit of confusion on who should be on what team at the beginning there, but it looks like they got things sorted out. As we go into game number two, Cooks here trying to push up the wall, stopped by Mikageshi. Mike just waiting patiently for that ball to drop. Gets a good catch off the corner. Markey, wide rotation coming from Flipside, see if they get a play started up. He challenges that one, wins it. Cooks here with the follow-up. And there's our first goal of game two.
Coming out so strong. This is exactly what I want to see out of him. This pass from Cooks here, read by Markey so well, passing it off that back wall, beating just in time the precision player. Then Cooks here following up for the pass. That was just a nice two-player passing play. And that is what they need to keep up.
The best part, too, that Cooks here had all options covered. Even if he had just touched the ball there, it would have been set up for another pass for his teammates there. But it doesn't matter. The ball went in, but a little bit of opening on the defense. Cooks here gets her in time, so no play can develop for Precision Z. Off the wall is Tequilas. Dudu just waiting to get a pass out. He does. Can he follow it up? A little bit too high. Arcing over that one. Mike losing the challenge on that. So is Mikageshi. Markey's going to clean it up. Back to the other side. Cooks here and Mikageshi rushing for this one. Goes in favor of Cooks here. He's up in the air. The follow-up, get the challenge by Mike. He can't. Markey with the shot to the far side. Cooks here tries to get a redirect or at least keep the ball in their possession.
I thought you were going
to
go in. I think he actually just blocked his own net. I think he thought someone went back. Two players from Precision actually went out for that to follow up that ball, and that's what you really can't do. You want to follow up your defensive touches, but not at the expense of leaving the net completely open. You need to leave somebody in net until it's at least out of your half.
Tequilas and his teammates trying to get a play set up. Dudu missing that one. Tequilas still in a good spot to roll that around the wall. Not a very good hit. Allows Cooks here to take control. Push it down for his teammate. But the shot, the redirect almost into his own net. Could have been a very bad situation putting them down two goals. Thankfully, it missed. Dudu into the zone. Cooks here throws that right to Markey. Markey with the drop down. Can someone follow it up? Almost. Tequilas gets a touch instead.
So close. Flipside's having so many opportunities where if they were just a little bit faster to the ball, they'd have these beautiful shots on a net, but they're just taking a little bit too long sometimes. I don't know, again, if it's because they're expecting their solo plays to make a little bit more or they're a little too timid right now. Since they haven't been getting as many and since their wins have been a lot tighter, they're probably playing a little bit more passive.
It makes sense. I mean, they're one up on the scoreboard, and that's all that matters at this point. Still 3 minutes left. Lots of time for Precision Z to come back. Tequila with the shot. Mikageshi trying to keep control. Tequila's with the feels back flip. That's going to allow Flipside to move into their area, but they don't put the pressure on Cooks here. Push into the side. Mike popping that one right over one of the defenders for Precision Z. Mikageshi, the last one back, gets a good touch. The second touch, very good play. Almost gets it past the second attacker, but it doesn't. Still stuck in their zone. 2.5 minutes is the mark we're reaching up on now. Mike Rule's trying to set a play up. Markey's going to be up there instead. Hearing him, he leaves him to it. Doesn't get the follow-up to do. Cooks here just drops out for his teammate. Can he get a second touch? He can, but not in his favor. Tequilas almost with an open net, and he gets it right past. Very good second touch.
There was a little bit of a mistake right here when Cooks here touched this for the second time. Mike actually didn't go straight to net. I think he was expecting a shot as opposed to Tequilas keeping control. And that right there is the difference between just shooting to shoot or keeping control and turning the play into something you're in control of.
Absolutely. Tying this one up. 2 minutes left in this match. First game was going to Flipside. Precision Z with 0 points so far. See if they can get one. All they need is one goal and then to wait out the rest of the game or get a few and dominate it. But they're stuck in their own area as Cooks here tries to get a play started up to do. Easy clear out to mid. Mikageshi gets a second touch. Now they're on the attack. Bounce. He doesn't read it properly, but Tequilas does. Gets stuffed out. That's going to not be a goal to do. Trying to set up another one. Mikageshi once again there for the second touch. Very good job supporting any of those clears from his teammates.
That slow touch right there by Flipside. He popped it up instead of out, which gave his player the second touch. While they weren't able to keep the pressure up, that's the kind of defensive plays that both these teams need to be making since they're against these powerhouses that are so hard at counter clearing.
Tequilas had a good touch there, but gets bumped out by a Flipside member. Shot on target, blocked easily by one of the two defenders. Markey almost getting it past that attacker. Doesn't quite. Back to midfield. Cooks here has the dribble opportunity. Gets the pop-up. Can Markey finish it off? Off the backboard and the third rotation. Can he get it? No, they're going to leave it for Tequilas to clear back. Would have been a great play. Now Tequilas trying to set up one of his own. Mike off the backboard misses it, but Markey to finish it up off the ground. The shot on target. Cooks here barely keeping that one out. The pressure is on from Precision Z, but back to their zone. Open net. Mike has to beat one. But he doesn't get the touch first.
Cooks here. Man, that save. All of his saves. He's so clutch. He gets it there so quick. He reads all the touches so well. Thank God that he's going to beat
shot.
It.
Oh. Oh, and Cooks here finishes at 40 seconds left, and now they're up on the scoreboard.
Defense and offense. Look at him. He's so well-rounded. He's able to do what he wants. When you give him time, he's going to put it on net. And he had all the time in the world for that. He's able to put it in. Almost some precision getting in there, but he couldn't jump up quick enough. Bouncing off his hood right into the back of that net.
Markey on the kickoff with Tequilas. Tequilas wins that one out. Cooks here takes control. No, he doesn't. Mikageshi takes it instead. Mikageshi doing a very good job offensively. Oh, gets it back out. Can he get the touch? No. Tequila's a little bit too late on that one. Markey now with the mind game to get past one. Can he get past two? The 1v1s. Can he get it? He can't. It's stopped out by Dudu.
I mean, these guys are some of the nastiest 1v1 players I know. You never, ever want to let the ball get on their hood and give them time. I mean, he just almost shook all three players solo. And that's kind of what Flipside does really well. But now the teams are getting better and they're catching up to their skill level. It's harder for them to be able to do that consistently.
Shot on target. This is an open net. Markey just has to put it on strong, and he does to solidify the win for this. 6 seconds would be very hard to come back for two goals.
Two people going up for this, while it was kind of risky, it's one of those situations where there's only 5 seconds left. You want to get a counter clear. I think they might be hoping for a pinch where they were both just kind of scared. They both thought they had a great hit. And then that's for the moment when you know you got a counterattack. It happens.
Desperate times call for desperate measures. And that's another one. Very close. I mean, 2 seconds. I mean, they could get even two more goals if they do that again.
They could pull. I mean, there's a chance. If this happens again, we're going to be down in 2 seconds. So they have 4 whole seconds. There's a chance. I mean, we've seen already this ball at 0 seconds stay up in the air for another 15 to 20.
I like Tequila's little dance on his rear end there at the end just to taunt out, hey, I got one. But they can't get another one. And that's going to be Flipside Tactics taking another one off of Precision Z. Trying to go for the 5-0. We'll see if they can carry it through. Playing very strong. I mean, it could be stronger. Again, as we've said, we love to see some more passes coming out. It's hard to just do those 1v1s, especially with teams like this. You're in the top eight. These guys can handle a bit of 1v1.
I mean, these wins haven't been too big. I mean, we just saw a 1-point win, and they were tied for a while. And last game was another one. It was an overtime, a 1-goal game. I think it was last game, right?
The overtime was last.
Yeah, okay. I'm losing my mind. But that's not, like, flip side, they need to make sure they carry this through because they really do need a lot of wins to make sure they maintain the position that they're in. And not doing that could be, just to reiterate, we're playing all games because every single game matters. This is not a best of
every
five.
Single game.
This is a match. So all five count. It doesn't matter who gets more, who gets less. These are points that go towards your total record. So every single win counts for both of these teams.
All the points, and we've said it before, sometimes you could be on tilt, but you don't ever want to be a tilt, especially in a series of five, because then you lose those points out. It's not like it's over after this next one.
Yeah.
You got to play them all out. You may as well stay in a good mindset.
And with EU, as we know, the depth is so strong. All the teams, you know, we see people coming out of the woodwork all over the place, making sure that they contest these top four spots. So every team, no matter how good they think they are, needs to be fighting for these points.
Well, we could easily see, maybe not easily, but we could see Precision Z come back and take a 3-2 in the series. So we're into game three, 10 seconds in, already an attack from Precision Z, but they get pushed back into their end. Mikageshi just boosting up. See if he can get a touch on it, and he gets beat out by Mike Rules, taking that off of his nose.
Came from off the wall. He almost got there in time. Kugzir hitting that sweet spot in that corner. Such good placement. He knew it would come across. It left Mikageshi in a tough spot because no one was in net. That's really, like, even if someone was from net, they might not have made it there in time because that shot was just so high and so quick.
Did his darndest, but it wasn't darndest enough as we go. First goal, only 20 seconds into the match. Markey off the backboard. Can it be followed up? There's a Precision Z player there to stop that play from developing any further. Dudu loses it on that one. Mike Rose shot on target. Tequila's with a stop, but still could be some shots on net now that could go in as Cooks here just pushing his way through. The Batmobile playing strong. Doesn't get a good touch on that one, though. Markey trying to support him, but the push out from Dudu could be an attack for Precision Z as they move into Flipside's area. Ooh, Ooh, the shot from Mika Geishi.
Oh.
Neither defender getting a good enough touch.
That floated for so long, I just kind of went quiet and just listened and waited. Mike didn't have the hit he wanted. He wanted to clear that really hard. None of his players could actually follow that. That was so far off of the wall that it was a hard thing to predict. I think they were all waiting for the harder pass. They were kind of expecting it. Trusting your teammate is one thing, but you know, that means that you need to make sure that the hits you're making are exactly what everyone's expecting you to make.
Oh, man, that ball just ricocheting off of three things, almost sinking into Flipside's net. But fortunately for them, it doesn't as they make an attack themselves. Dudu stopping that one in his track. Can he get another touch? No, he goes right around that. But there's Tequilas with the long shot, open net. A little bit stronger, could have been in. Maybe on the far side would have been a good shot too, but it stopped out, still 1-1. A minute 20 into this match as Precision Z tries to get a point for themselves.
Precision, is, you know, in the beginning of this game, I was actually going to make a comment that they're not following up their defensive touches as much. They were kind of giving possession. But now they're doing a little bit more. Now you can see they're keeping the pressure on the flip side half. Flip side isn't following their touches as well. But right here, look at this 1-2 pass out of their own half. It was actually contested really well by a Precision player. But those kind of touches are what you want to see.
Opportunity for Marky and Mike to get a play started up here. The pinch coming out shoots that way wide of the orange net as Flipside tries to get another play started up. Precision Z moving in with the pressure. Could be a pass out for a teammate. Almost a good touch, but contested there. Mike pushing that off the wall. Marky Duda to follow him up. There's a 1v1 situation. Two defenders there. Tequila pushes that one out. Mika Geishi off the wall. See if someone could follow it up. They're just going to leave that. But Cook's here to push back to midfield to Duda with a touch. Up in the air, just trying to keep the pressure on into Flipside's area. See if they can maybe outboost them, get some shots on net.
Flipside's doing the hard clear to try and buy themselves a little bit of time, but Precision doing a good job of countering it. It's been in the Flipside half for a while. This is the first time we've seen a hard clear. Let's see if they can keep the pressure up.
Oh, just shot the angle! Almost in, and no one to follow it up. Could have been an amazing shot, and there it is. Oh, wow, the shot's coming out. Cooks here finally finishing it off.
Look at that, 4 or 5 shots, this volley.
100,000 shots.
Like on a pirate ship with all the cannons facing right into the net. There's nothing they could do about it. So many shots. That's the tight rotations that I want to see. They're showing it once in a while. Every now and then they get that tight rotation that Flipside does where they just do shot, 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 shot. But it's not as much as I'm used to seeing out of them.
And they spent so much time in their own end, and then when they finally break out, they get a goal. Precision Z is going to have to just keep them in their own end. Then they want to catch up. Only one goal deficit, 2 minutes left, lots and lots of time. As long as they don't give possession away too much. Marky taking this pass, all three. Cooks here, there to support him. Marky almost getting a shot, but there's Mika Geishi to push it to the side. Let's even get a push out of their own end. Dudu losing the contest. Tequila's was a little too far up, so Mika Geishi's going to push instead. Marky off the wall, back to midfield. Doesn't like it in their end. Says, let's get another goal. It's too close right now. Still sitting at midfield. See if a shot can go off the backboard. Mike up, trying to get the redirect. Doesn't quite connect.
The reads are doing really well. Flipside's, they're clicking. They're getting those reads down. They're predicting all the crazy wall touches. They got to make sure they rotate back on defense, though. That was a little bit scary having to come from the side. You know, when you're coming to defend a ball from the side, you have to time it a lot more perfectly. You can't make that mistake or boost, and it leaves a lot of room for the player that's shooting it to either not shoot at all and just mess you up altogether or shoot it at a weird angle.
Yeah, it's not a situation you want to be in. It's definitely not advantageous, but that's on target. Mika Geishi barely keeping that one. Maybe thought it was going to go off an opponent's car there. Marky now just waiting. Going to leave that for Mike. Up the wall is Dudu. Misses that one. It's going to allow Mike to push out. Cooksier's waiting back for this to fall off the wall. Shot from Tequilas, good positioning from Cooks here. Keeps that from going in front of the net. Marky backwards, gets that pass Mika Geishi. Can he get past to Dudu? He can't. Mike is going to be up, though, to push that way deep. Is that an open net? It is. And that's going to put him up 3-1, under a minute left.
I'm going to give this goal up to Flipside's defensive rotation. They have been so good at keeping people in net. Precision's been doing their best to try and make sure they get opportunities, and they just aren't making any. It's not that they're performing poorly. It's that Flipside's defensive rotations are so tight. There's always somebody in net and always contesting it.
Being challenged at every shot, absolutely correct. And it's very hard to put one in the net when there's someone in the way every time. Cooks here to the side to Mike. See if Mike followed up. They're probably going to try for at least one more. Don't see them slowing down. They want to be on those stat boards by Rawlings. See if they can get another goal. Tequilas. Good touch to midfield. No one's following it up, though. No pressure for Precision Z. They want to get out of the zone. They're going to have to, especially with 30 seconds left. Two goals is possible. Just very, very hard. You can't do it when you're in your own end. Challenge from Cooks here. It's one out. Shot from Mika Geishi on the backboard. Dudu can finish it up. Oh, and it's not going to get pushed out. Mika Geishi gets credit for that one.
20 seconds. There's still a shot. They're keeping it close. Precision is not. They're going down fighting. coming off the wall. Mika Geishi coming.
Great shot.
Right into the corner. That is not an easy shot to make at all. I believe he even used a second jump at the very last second. Right before he lost it, you only have around two and a half seconds. About two and a half seconds to actually use your second jump before you no longer have the ability to. So it looks like he waited for that prime moment until he just about lost it.
Seal, 10 seconds left. They can still do this on the attack, but they get beat out. Cooks here throwing that way back into the net. That could be in and almost get finished off, but that's looking to be dead, and it touches the ground as Flipside takes yet another one.
There's one thing that I can see Flipside does insanely well, and it's when they're going up for a contest, and they're going to contest somebody, and they know they've lost it. They actually put themselves in a place to still kind of body it and get in the way of the shot. Like, they know they're about to lose it, and they know that they're like, oh, man, I'm actually not going to make it in time. So instead of going for the ball, they're actually going for where they know the other player is going to hit it and get in the way. And that's how they've actually made a lot of their opportunities on net.
Well, we're seeing a much stronger Precision Z coming out as these games go on. Hopefully, for their sake, we'll see them take a game in the next two. Do you think it's possible, or do you think Flipside keeps pushing through?
I think it's insanely possible. Every single game's been up to 1 point, and most of those points are scored in the last minute. So I think it's actually very, very possible for Precision Z. Like I said, they may be down in the series right now. I think it's 3-2, or 3-0 right now?
It's 3-0.
3-0, 3-2. All five haven't played yet. It's 3-0, and remember, we play every single game because every point matters. Every game is a point. So Precision Z needs to get these two wins, and I think they're so, so capable of pulling it off.
All right, well, we'll find out as all the players are ready and excited to get into the next match. I'm going to chill it down. No spectators this time. With the birds and the bees, they're going to be hanging out with us today.
Listen to the nature.
The nature. That might be the calming effect. Maybe that's what they're trying to do with this counter pick. Precision Z is trying to just slow down. Flipside, hey, calm down, guys. Let us get some shots. We'll see, though, as they almost get a breakout right off the kickoff. To do up on the wall to keep that pushing forward. Being out by Cooks here in the air. Tequilas, that long car, getting the stuff off the wall. Can he get a shot? He does. Not very strong, though. It's going to be an easy save for Markey.
Putting the shots on target, like I said, that was actually a good one because you pulled the defender out. If someone was able to follow up, it would have been good. But you got to be careful not to give up possession or give up a hard clear. As we saw, if you overcommit, you can.
Oh, a lot of shots just on fire from Flipside, and finally sinking one is Cooks.
Flipside starting early. Markey with a great contest. He didn't even use a second jump. He just bodied it, got in the way, made sure that when his favorite stayed
bodied.
In. Bodied. Sorry, bodied it. Bodied it?
Bodied. Now bodied works.
You know what? Now it's self-conscious.
Like
No, I just like
the word. All right, one up. Already 30 seconds in. Markey tried to get another, but Dedu stuffs that one. Tequila's up on the wall waiting for the pass. A little bit of a miss there is going to allow Flipside to move back into an open net, just missing. But the finish from Cooks here, easy peasy.
Easy peasy is right. Cooks didn't have to do a whole lot for this. He beat that last defender way, way over commitment.
Look how slow he goes
precision.
In.
He just took his time, but he should have. That's what you want to do. I'm assuming someone on his team's like, you got time. That's one of the biggest things. Because if he fell under pressure or he thought he had time and someone was able to come and sweep that, it would have been really, really bad. So communication and points like that is great. You need to have a teammate letting you know, like, he's coming up on you. You don't have the time, or like, oh, you got all the time in the world. Just make the shot.
Feeling the vibe of the map. He slows it down, takes a stroll in the park, and gets another goal on the scoreboard for Flipside. Still under a minute of play, already up two. It's a very tough way to start for Precision Z, but there is Dedu with an answer to that last one.
I think someone got Goomba stomped. We were watching over here. I think in goal, someone went to go jump up. And Mika actually got in his way. I couldn't tell. I really wish I saw the angle, but Markey was just kind of flat-footed, flat-wheeled, all-wheeled, four-wheeled.
A demo helped as well, too. Looked like Cooks here got demoed, or one of the Batmobiles. I saw the Batman insignia there. Shot coming out from Precision Z a little bit wide. One goal down now, just over a minute of play in. Already seen three goals. High-scoring game. We'll see if they can keep it up. Tequila's down to Mika Geishi. Good play off the wall there. It wasn't on target. Markey Duda, easy push to the side. Back is Cooks here. Try to roll it up the wall. Good touch. See if we can follow it up. Tequilas beats him to it. This is a play out front. Shot coming from Mika Geishi. Sinking that one. He had a lot of time.
Where was Mike? Cooks here come up. Markey, where was Mike?
He's way over there.
He just let his team down. Something might have happened. He could have been bumped. Weren't able to see that far back in the past. But Mike was nowhere to be seen. Both Flipside players actually chasing that out, trying to get the double touch, trying to get it out of their half. But again, leaving that net open. Let's Precision tie the game up.
As you said, now we have a tie game. A minute and a half in, 2-2. Mika Geishi trying to push it forward for another one. Very hard to keep control of that one, but he still manages to get a pass out. Cooksier takes control to Mike. Some good passing plays. Dadu gets a good touch. Otherwise, could have been scary as Mike was following that one up. Dadu needs to get another good touch. He does. Cooksier steals it from him. Shot on net. Tequilas. Good clear to midfield. Mike throwing it right back in. Cooksier, can he get the redirect? Oh. Off the crossbar. Great shot.
These reads, just when I thought that Precision had a little bit of time to gather up because they weren't able to put anybody back in net, you saw them retreat, but then Cooksier redirecting that.
Absolutely beautiful shot.
Right to the top post. There's almost nothing you can do about that. You would have had to predict that was so fast.
Those are hard to save regardless if you know it's going to hit the crossbar because it could bounce anywhere.
Yeah.
Into the net, out of the net, or go off the backboard. Now they're up. A goal, but Tequilas keeps that away from Mike. Mike almost got another one. Pressure coming out from Flipside Tactics right now. Off the wall, Mike. To Marky. Cooksier is there to support him, but the shot's on net. Mikageshi just pushing that one out. Cooksier missing the flip. It's going to allow Mikageshi to make an attack. Tequilas Dadu not close enough to support him. They're going to have to move back into their zone. Tequilas off of wall, down to Dadu. Dadu gets a good clear. Cooksier in a bad spot to follow it up. Dadu does instead the shot. Marky just drops that to the side to stop any play from developing.
Cooksier knowing very well to just sit him.
Oh, Mike, can he do it? Almost getting the dribble past all three.
This is what their 1v1 play is insane. Mike, Mark, even Cooksier, you don't want to give them any room anytime. They can dribble like monsters. Right now, you see all three players up. They're overcommitting a bit, but they're not getting punished right now by Precision.
That's absolutely true. They're just waiting back too much sometimes. Too much room to flip side, although see if they get a shot. Dadu with the second touch, and he does!
Oh!
Amazing shot! Look at the pass play.
He got there just in time. Someone is actually going to block that. These redirects are working so well. Why do they work so well, you ask? Oh, thank you for asking that question, Brody. Redirects actually mess everyone up because they have this, especially when you're on ball cam, you think you know where the ball is going and it's about to go somewhere. And the guy that's redirecting it has so many options. He can put it to so many places along the net,
almost
and there's
anywhere.
Almost no way to know. If someone's driving dead at the ball, you have a good idea of where he's going. But if someone's going to redirect it, you have no clue where he's going to put it, and it just messes everything up.
Very, very hard to read, as you said. Cooksier generally does a good job of that, but couldn't on that one. It goes right over his head. Now it's a tie game once again. Precision Z really wants this point to do with the back touch. Pushing to the side instead of on target. Could have been a smart play, but no one followed up. Marky takes control instead. Can he get the air dribble? Second touch. Can he do it? Oh, my goodness.
Oh,
Marky Duda.
Marky
Duda.
To take the lead. Wow, it's a tie game. Oh, man. He gets that second touch. He gets up underneath. He gets the third touch just in time. The defender came up, got a little too impatient, wasn't ready for it. But when you see Marky on the ball, you got to be ready. You have to know he's going to do it. He had the time. He had the room. He needed to be contested just a little bit sooner. But, man, that is hard to read no matter what, how good of a defender you are.
Incredible play from Marky Duda, putting them up a goal, but we have seen a lot of their goals answered pretty quickly by Precision Z. We'll see if they can do it again as they're already back on the attack. No one follows up. Marky Duda just playing that one easy on the ground, throws it up to Mike. Mike gets the touch off the backboard. Let's see if they can finish it up. Almost! And there's another shot off. Cooksier just waiting back, seeing that Tequilas had the clear on it, but not a good enough clear. Now he chases it himself. Good boost steal from Cooksier is going to make it hard if they can keep the pressure on, and they do. It's going to be a hard defensive situation for Precision Z. They're all at a boost. Mike steals the other one as well. Now they're going to get stuck in their zone. There's an opportunity to take a shot on net and get a goal. Put them up two instead of one on the scoreboard.
One good thing the Flipside can do is since all three players are so good individually, they can actually confidently leave a player in the back while the other two guys go for attack because they know they're going to do something really well at it. But the problem is, since they're all so good, they all sometimes want to come up, and that's where some overcommitments happen once in a while, which is where Precision Z is able to get some good counterattacks, and that's where they've gotten some of their goals.
30 seconds left. If Precision Z wants to take a point on this one, it's a very close game. It could be an opportunity. Off the backboard, followed up. Mike Rules gets a second touch, not on target. Marky couldn't get a touch himself. Cooks here with the long shot. Going to be off the backboard. Good touch from Mikageshi, good read. Could have been a scary situation. Now, challenge Mike Rules! Wins the contest, puts him up two goals with 10 seconds left.
This goes to show how close these players are in predicting. They both tried to predict it. One just got predicted the tiniest bit earlier, a tiny bit
that
higher.
It went off of a player.
Actually, just to let you guys know, if you ever see the trail of the ball change colors, that shows you which color team touched it last. So if you notice the trail on that ball went orange, that means it actually did bounce off of a Precision player before it went into net.
5 seconds left, looking to be like another win for Flipside as they try to get another one. And that ball is going to drop. And a very strong showing from Precision Z, but they just, at the end, lost out on a couple goals. They still have a chance to get a point on this as we go into the next game.
Still, again, this is the only game that's been bigger than a one-point lead. And they keep it so well, they were tied up until like the last minute again. Precision Z is keeping this so close. So close.
And I love it. I love that it's not a blowout or anything. I mean, on paper, it might look at it like that at the end, but if you're watching the games, this is super close. Goals are being answered very quick. They're not letting Flipside stay up on the scoreboard for very long.
They really are, and they're making those confusing plays. They're doing the redirects. They're doing the passing plays. They're being consistent. They just need to make sure that they don't let Flipside, if you give them the room, if you give them more than 2 seconds to take a shot, it's going to be perfectly on target. But Flipside has had some shots that they probably really should have been a little more accurate on. We've seen a lot of post shots coming out of Markey and Mike, even Cooks here, where it easily could have been a goal. I mean, some of these could have been much more promising, but their accuracy is a little bit off. It's hard to know why that is.
Well, I'm not sure. Again, as we mentioned before, they are going for those 1v1 plays, maybe some more pass plays. Just just make that net open.
Yeah,
pull
open it up
the defense out. Get them psyched out and get some shots where it's an open net. It's hard to miss those.
Yeah. While they are good at threading the needle and making sure that they take the shots in the tight spots, they need to open up the net more, like you said, just so that they have a more sure shot.
Well, quick question for you coming into this next game. Is there anything specifically you think the Precision C has to do to pull away with a point?
I think they need to keep their offense on going just a little bit longer. They've had some opportunities where they're just one or two more shots away from fully breaking that Flipside defense. So if they can keep that going a little bit more, be confident, trust each other, keep going for it, and just try not to be too scared of those counterattacks, I think they can kind of clutch a win here.
All right, we'll see if they can do that. Already in their own zone though, Flipside putting the pressure on. Could be a shot here. Mika Geishi was a little under it. A little scary as Markey almost dropped one in. Back in the Flipside zone, that's a pop up right in front of the net. Cooks here. Good idea to get up there before Tequilas does. Second touch. Going to get that one out to Mike. Good patience from Mike to wait for that second touch, recognizing Cooks here would make it. Doesn't get the stop on Mika Geishi as he pushes it back to midfield.
They're quick to the ball. They're getting there fast. They're not letting any opportunities happen. But again, in the first minute, you generally see slower play come out of both teams. Sometimes they come out kicking. But right now, Flipside knows that they've already got four. They want the five. They want to take it, especially since they didn't get it last series. They want to make sure they get this 5-0.
Yeah, that's on target, and the redirect from Markey as someone was falling off the backboard, but a little bit of a weird situation.
That was insane. He came there just in time. I actually thought it was going to get saved. Dadu was there. Markey getting there last second.
Wow, yes.
What? I can't tell if Dadu was actually going to make it.
I mean, hard from that angle, but it did look like the nose would at least get on it. Maybe not a good touch, but not in the net at the very least. But the redirect puts him up. Minute in already on the scoreboard. We'll see, as we said, Precision C, very good job of answering these. Tequilas waiting for a shot. Cooks here, really soft touch on that. Mike's trying to do anything to keep control as they flop around in the corner. It seems to work, but Mika Geishi getting the butt on that, pinches that out to the side. Call that a butt clench. And then, and now shot out. Markey, if he can get the redirect again, the second touch. Oh no, Mike, off the crossbar. Very smart play though.
Again, that's where the accuracy comes into play. They could have another goal that was so close to going in. Ooh, reading that air dribble so well. I've seen some players do it at this high level. With this fast level of play, and they want to get up really quick, before you jump up, you want to make sure your car is lined up, because I've seen some people, we saw Cooks here do it with a little weak touch earlier.
Oh, good pass from Mike, and there's Cooks here to finish it off. He carried that through the entire net and waited. If no one was there, that was good option coverage from Mike.
Yeah, it was. He saw someone come by. He wasn't able to take it on. He didn't put it on target because he knew they might have gotten the clear. It was a bit of a whiff on the side of Precision. They probably should have had that clear. You saw a player just fly by. He just whizzed by that.
Took up the camera.
Yeah.
All right, well, two up already. No answering goal from Precision Z yet. 2 minutes into the match. 3 minutes left. Lots of time for them to pull back. We know they can get some goals. They just need to do it quick. They don't want to stay down. Pressure coming up from Markey. Cooks here to bounce that off the wall. It's going to be a good pass, but up is Tequilas to keep that out. Mika Geishi waiting for another shot. There it is. Doesn't get the block. He does get the block. That one halfway in the net. And we'll see if another shot. Markey pushing it in for a third goal.
Flipside's putting Precision on the wire right now. We had a save there, but no one was able to contest it yet again. It just kind of bounced. Another whiff. They're getting a little bit flustered right now. They're letting Flipside do what Flipside does, and it's keep the pressure on. There's a couple. Already we've had two defensive whiffs that kind of resulted in goals.
We'll see, though, if they start overcommitting, Precision C may be able to take advantage of an open net. Hopefully, they're maybe hoping for that, get some long shots, but they at least need to get some shots on net first to show that they can stand up in this last game. Markey waiting and waiting patiently to get a good play started up, throws it up. Mika Geishi also had a lot of time, letting him get to stuff that play from advancing. Dadu and Markey almost winning that into the neutral. We're gonna see it still sit in the neutral as no team really takes control of it. Mike has a chance to set up a play. Tequilas catches that off the wall. His teammates follow him up. The roll-up could be a play for Precision C, but already Flipside back on that defense.
This is the biggest lead we've seen yet in this match, and I think it's because Precision Z's defense is finally caving in. I mentioned it in the beginning. If they let Flipside take too many shots, eventually their defense is just going to be tough to keep up. You're going to get just mentally drained from having to block all these shots and predict all these touches, and eventually it's just going to start becoming overwhelming.
That's right, Marky with a shot to the far side. To do is nowhere in place to get up in time.
Like I said, this is actually Tequila's another whiff. Tequila thought he had it. He wasn't able to get there just in time. No one was able to rotate quick enough. Marky seeing the opening, putting it to the top of the net. It's so hard to jump up for those, so he just had a pretty easy coast in.
4-0 on the scoreboard, 2 minutes left. Mikageshi has a chance for a goal here, just waits and gets a stop at least. Dedu up, can he get the redirect? He can get the shot on, that's in front of the net, but no one to finish it off. They need some goals quick if they want to walk away with a point and not a 5-0. That's an open net. If Tequila's Mikageshi, one of them, can get it in, they don't.
Mikageshi wanted to do the mind games. He was waiting to try and suck that defender out, but I think Tequila's wanted to take that shot while he's had the opportunity. No one got the power on it they needed. But they need to make sure those opportunities are happening more often than they actually are right now.
Ooh, Marky almost pushing one in, but Tequila's keeps that out. Let's see if they can move on to the attack as Cooks here gets some boost. Passes that right out to Mike. Shot on net. Back to Mikageshi up the wall. The second touch loses out on that as Cooks here gets it. Mike Rule's waiting to see if he can challenge Dedu. Bad touch from Dedu, but thankfully for them, no one from Flipside was there to get the touch. Now they can make a push out to do it. And Mikageshi ready for a setup to do with the second touch, but that's going to drop down from Mike. Mike takes that instead of Mikageshi. Mikageshi does stop the play from advancing. And now they're back on the attack. Precision Z, 45 seconds left. There's the shot. Tequila's with their first goal.
That was such a fluster getting to this area. It was just in the middle. Everyone was touching it back and forth. All six players were just like whizzing by each other. Tequila's seeing the opportunity. No one rotated back quick enough on Flipside, but I think they know with this lead, it's pretty promising. 3 points in 43 seconds. They're probably a little more lax, just having a little bit of fun.
We have seen some quick goals, but never a win from Precision Z. Maybe they can do it, but not looking too bright for their future. Dedu up in the air, beaten out by Cooks here, it looked like. Now we're back to midfield. Mikageshi with a nice lob. Marky Duda going to block that one to the side. Cooks here with a pinch off the wall, not a very good one. Marky is going to lose that to Tequila's, but Tequila's weird bounce goes back to Dedu. Can Dedu get a shot? Not on target. Easy block for Cooks here and Mike. So keep that out. 14 seconds left. Not looking very good.
Looking a little bleak for Precision. This is the kind of time when, you know, you just kind of accept your defeat. They still have more games to play today, so they need to keep their heads up, keep their heads strong. They played very, very well.
They played strong.
This is supposed to be one of the hardest teams in their schedule. They played very strong. Every single game was 1 point for the first three, then 2 points, and then finally 3 points. It seemed to slowly ramp up. But again, you just get mentally exhausted dealing with a team like this. Flipside can keep that pressure on, keep those shots, and it's just so hard to keep that up for five whole games.
Yeah, and again, not on paper. People are going to look at the 5-0, but it was close. I recommend, if you didn't see them all, go back and watch them all. Precision Z did a very, very good job of keeping up to Flipside tactics. We're going to go over to the analyst desk right now so they can say just how close it was as well.
Thank you, Brody and the Beard. We're back at the desk. Scott Cole along with James and Wave. Flipside has won 8 straight games for the first team the group stage to reach 20 wins.
Yeah, they are on the fast track to becoming the number one team in the groups right now. And really, as Carpet said, those first three games were one goal games, but interestingly, in the entire series, Precision Z never took the lead. So Flipside really had a good command over the series, even though the games were close.
Yeah, very, very close games going off. And I was happy to see Precision Z warming up as the series went on. The very beginning, we had 0-0, one goal in the favor of Flipside. And then kind of, you know, just more and more, though, as it went on, we saw Precision Z warming up, finally actually getting out of their own half. They were on defense so much in that first beginning of the series. And then we saw it going a little bit more back and forth. But yeah, Flipside taking it all 5-0.
Yeah, nice job. Flip keeps rocking and rolling. Let's take a look at it. On the replay, a 5-0 win by Flipside.
I honestly felt like Cookser stepped it up big time. You see, he gets that pass right off Marky, who actually passes to himself, gets it off the backboard again. Cooks was there. He was so good on the rebounds this game.
They scored 16 goals this series. 10 of those involved Cookser in some ways, 7 of which were he scored by himself. This man was on fire on offense. The other big player, though, was Marky.
Yeah, Marky was insane. He He was kind of quiet, actually. And you see, again, Cooksier on the rebound, sick. But honestly, the goal of the series for me was Marky Duda's air dribble. That thing was absolutely insane. Marky had no goals up to this point. And then he busts out this air dribble, getting it past the defense. It was unbelievable. That was what kickstarted Marky in this series. And guess what? The following game, he got a hat trick. So unbelievable play from Marky.
Yeah, no, Marky really coming up clutch there. Of those 16 goals I was talking about, five of them were scored by Marky. He warmed up really big in game four and game five. So Cooksier taking the beginning of the series, passing it off to Marky, letting him take the end of it, and just taking all just dominant offensive control the entire game.
Yeah, what can you say? Flipside is on a roll. By the way, the Flying Dutchman did beat Solid 4-1. Maybe the match of the day coming up next. Mockett will be taking on Weedham Girls. Who is going to be first after this one? You'll have to stick around to find out. We'll be right back. Rocket League Championship Series right here on Twitch.